Hey, this is Peter again. In this video, I want to talk about rows and columns, which are the building blocks of SmartSlider. By default, layers are placed below one another, but with rows and columns, you can put layers next to one another. Rows are the containers of the columns, and columns can contain any layer including other rows. This way, you can create more complicated layouts. Let's take a look at this simple example. I'll work with this layout to show you the options of the rows and columns. There is a row which contains three columns. If you open the layer list, you will see that the structure also appears here. Click on the arrow icon to open the row and see the three columns inside. In each column, there is an image, a heading, and a text layer. Select the row from the layer list to see its settings. These green boxes are the columns of the row. You can adjust the width of the columns by dragging the vertical lines between them. Click on the Add Column button if you need more columns. Do you need the column in a different position? Simply drag and drop the column to the right place. In the Layer menu, you have an option to duplicate or delete a column. I don't need this empty one, so I will delete it. You can select a row directly on the canvas too. Just click on it. Use the Inner Align option on the column to align the layers inside to the left, center, or right side. The gutter is the distance between the columns. The wrap after decides how many columns can fit in one line inside the row. For example, setting it to 2 makes the first two columns stay next to each other, and the third wraps below them. You can set different values for tablet or mobile, with the options which are marked with the device icon. When the stretch is turned on, the row stretches all the way up and down to fill the available vertical space. If you want to edit a column, you can reach it from the row by clicking on the green box which represents it. You can change the inner align on each column separately. With the vertical align option, you can adjust the vertical position of the layers inside a column. Let's see the available styling options of a column. You can set a background image to the column or a background color. With the padding, you can create some space around your layers. All columns in the same line have the same height inside the row. If one column gets taller than the others, it increases the height of the others as well. Let's see the available options of the row. Use the layer menu of the column to easily navigate to the row. As you can see, the row has the same styling options as the column. Now I will show you how to add the new row. Click on the Add button and select the row layer. You can place it inside a column or below the other row. It's time to add layers. I want a button layer in each column. Just drag the layer and drop it into the column. Or select a column and click on a layer which you want to add. When the Full Width option is turned on, the row fills its container horizontally. Otherwise, it tries to be as wide as the content inside. I want to put this row inside my middle column, so I place it there by dragging. If you open the layer list, you will see that the row is inside my column. That's all you need to know about the rows and columns. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please hit the like button. If you want more awesome tutorials, then subscribe to our channel. See you in the next video!